Assalamualaikum and good morning. Today we are going to study chapter 1, matter. 1.1 is about definition and classification. So today we are going to study about this one first. And one more chapter that we are going to study is 1.2, state of matter. This one, after we finish 1.1. So definition and classification. Learning outcome. At the end of this topic, you should be able to define what is matter. Classify matter into pure substance, element and compound, and mixture, homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture. So let's see examples of matter. Matter is anything that has mass and takes up space. Sometimes the space here we also call volume. So this person has mass and volume. Glasses has mass and volume. Butterfly, the same. Computer, coffee, desk, chair, cat, cloud, sun, plant, everything here is matter. So, what is matter? Yeah? So, matter, anything that takes up space and has mass. Example, we have seen earlier, it can be air, it can be water, it can be animals, it can be trees, it can be atoms. And matter may consist of atoms only, molecules, two or more atoms, or ion, positive and negatively charges ion. There are three states of matter. This one is simple. You have learned this before. So three states of matter: solid, liquid, and gas. Okay, matter can be classified. Okay, matter can be classified by two things: mixture. Okay, mixture, and also pure substance. Okay, mixture can be separated by physical method. Physical method means like filtration, sorting, that is physical. And mixtures can be further divided into homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. Okay, and pure substance can be further divided into compounds and elements. Okay, compounds can be separated by chemical method. Chemical method means something like electrolysis. That is chemical method, not physical. Okay, definition. Okay, we go one by one. So element. Okay, this one you need to know because this is from the learning outcome. So definition: pure substance that cannot be decomposed into simpler substance. Whether you are going to use chemical or physical reaction. For example, neon, helium, and aluminium. You cannot further decompose this. Neon, you cannot decompose to become anything else. It will always become neon. So, for example, helium. Helium here, okay, you see here, this is the shape of balloon. Balloon, because helium is used for floating balloon. Neon, as you can see here, this is actually neon light, okay, neon light, which give a very bright colors. Potassium, it contains a lot in banana. That's why K here is from banana. And aluminium here, aluminium that you can see here is looks like aluminium sheets. Okay, used as a wrapping. Okay, what about compound? Okay, compound composed of atoms of two or more elements chemically united or bonded in fixed proportion. Okay, for example, H2O, NH3, and glucose. And this one can be broken down into elements by chemical reaction. As I told you earlier, chemical reaction, it can be electrolysis. For example, water, you can separate this using electrolysis. Okay, let's see here, yeah, elements and compound. Elements contains only one kind of atom. Okay, it doesn't matter whether you have helium. Helium is mono atom, and oxygen is duatom. Okay, duatom. Even though it is two atom, this is still considered elements because it only contain one kind of atom. And compounds here, this is not elements. This is compound. Why? Because it contains two or more kind of atom. H2O containing one hydrogen and two oxygen. So this is compound, not element. But oxygen here is element. Okay, it is element. What about mixture? Okay, so mixture, a material of variable composition that contains two or more substances can be homogeneous or heterogeneous. Okay, example will be given here. So homogeneous mixture, a solution that have uniform properties. Okay, homogeneous means uniform. You cannot see the separation between them. For example, soft drink. Okay, for example, Coca-Cola. You cannot see the layer. Okay, because everything is uniformly mixed. Okay, and milk. You also see it as white. You cannot see the protein. You cannot see the water inside that because it is properly or uniformly mixed. Okay, whereby heterogeneous mixture, you can see the boundary or the layer. For example, you mix oil with water, you can see water at the bottom and oil at the top. If oil is less denser than water, so you can see the separation between oil and water. That's the difference. Heterogeneous mixture, there is the layer, the boundary between two or more mixture there. Okay, example. This is not air, this is air. So air is homogeneous. Air, you cannot see the separation between nitrogen, hydrogen, oxygen, because air is homogeneously mixed. Okay, salt water, you add salt with water, it is also homogeneous. Sugar water, also homogeneous. You cannot see the boundary. Brass is some kind of alloy. So a mixture of two metal, mixed brass, so you cannot see the separation. And solution, for example, sodium carbonate solution, HCl solution, you cannot see the separation. So that is homogeneous. Okay, heterogeneous, soil is tanah. So sometimes you can see, sometimes you need microscope to see the differences, but you can see the differences if you want to. Sand and water, okay, you add sand and water, you can still see the boundary between the sand particle and water. It does not mix homogeneously. Sometimes you must look very closely or even magnify to see different part. Okay, even for this part, you can still see the boundary. Yeah? Okay, what about pure substance? Okay, pure substance. Homogeneous sample of matter that always have the same composition and properties regardless of its source. Okay, substance can only be homogeneous and have constant composition. Okay, let's see example lah. It can be either classified as compound or element. Lah. Okay, so pure substance. So let's see pure substance. If it is chemical element, it can be tin. Tin is timah. It can be sulfur. It can be diamond. Okay, so all these are chemical element, which is pure substance. Compound, sugar. Also pure substance. Sugar is actually C6H12O6. Water is H2O. Still compound and it is pure substance. Baking soda, Na2CO3, so still pure substance. And crystal, salt crystal. Okay, salt is made up from NaCl and still pure substance. Protein crystal, still pure substance. And copper sulfate, still pure substance. Okay, so it is homogeneous. It must be homogeneous and have constant composition. Constant composition means that kandungan dia tu constant. For example, sugar. Sugar, you can see, sugar is always looks like that. Okay? It is always homogeneous. Sugar is always sugar. That is pure substance. Water is always looks like that. Okay? It have constant composition. Unless the water is contaminated, that is not pure substance anymore lah, because it is contaminated. Maybe contaminated by soil, contaminated by dirt particle. That's different. That is not pure substance anymore lah. Okay, so that's it for our lesson today, which is about definition and classification. You can refer to your notes that is already on the website and try to answer the Google form that I am going to include along with this notes. Okay, so that's it for today. So see you again. And remember to like and subscribe.